Welcome to a super casual interview. Oh gosh. All right, students, let's get into the answers for the handsomest drowned man in the world. This assignment is broken up into two sections. You have reading lit standard one and then reading literature standard two so that you can practice them independently. All right, the first question says, use a quote or an example from the text to explain how the children treat the drowned man when they find him. So my answer says, when the children find the dead man, they begin playing with him by, quote, burying him in the sand and digging him up again. Now, you can see I dropped my quote in there. I have my page number in there. Now, the punctuation is quotation mark, parentheses, page number, in punctuation. All right, now, the rest of mine don't have these cool page numbers because this is my super casual answer video and I was super lazy. So yours should probably have the page numbers though. Number two, use evidence from the text to explain how the women of the village react to the drowned man. My answer says the younger women of the village began looking at the drowned man with passion and secretly compared him to their own men. The oldest woman told the others, he has the face of someone called Esteban. They agree and begin to treat the dead man as if he were a saint. They piled trinkets and relics on his body to prepare him for his burial at sea to the point that the men asked why there was, quote, such a fuss over a drifting corpse. So you can see that I have dropped quotes in here throughout the answer so that you can, so that the reader can see my evidence from the text. Number three, what do the villagers decide to do after they bury the drowned man? This is a very straightforward question, right? You're just going to pull information from the text. So my answer says, the villagers decide to honor the drowned man by painting their houses bright colors and by, quote, digging for springs among the stones and planting flowers on the cliffs, end quote. All right, number four, use evidence from the text to explain how Marquez blurs the line between reality and fantasy in his story. My answer says Marquez begins blurring the line between reality and fantasy in the beginning when he says the children mistake the corpse for an enemy ship. The man's size is one way the line is blurred. Another way is how the women react to the corpse by treating it like the body of a saint. They even name him Esteban, like Saint Stephen from the Bible. When the men are upset, the women only have to reveal Esteban's face to the men and they understand the fuss all of a sudden. The village even, quote, chose a father and mother from among the best people, end quote, so that he would not be buried as an orphan. So I paraphrase some of the stuff that happens, and then I even drop a direct quote in there as my evidence. All right, moving on, part two. Reading List Standard 2 is about themes, and then also about your ability to summarize the story. So question 5 and 6 go hand in hand. So question 5 says, what is one theme from the story? Again, no one word answers here. Number 6 says, what is the evidence from the text that supports the theme you listed? So I have three options. Let's take them one at a time. So one theme from the story might be, people can draw inspiration from unlikely sources. And my evidence from that is that the villagers draw inspiration from a drowned man and decide to paint their houses and plant flowers to honor his memory. A second theme might be, the deceased should be respected. And then my evidence is that the villagers take great care with the corpse's body. They also ensure that the dead man does not belong to any nearby villages. Both of these actions indicate a respect for the deceased. The third example I have is that the act of naming, like just naming someone, begins to shape one's identity. So my evidence is that at first the body was a plaything for the children, and the younger women were creating an identity where the dead man's name might be Lautaro. But then the old woman named him Esteban, and then his saintly identity began to take form. So you remember, they call him Esteban, and that's when he really takes on the identity that he ends up having for the rest of the story. So the last question asks you to summarize the story. Now remember, this needs to be an objective summary, so just the facts as much as possible. Let's see how I did. A drowned man washed ashore in a village. Children find him and begin playing with him. When the adults discover what's happening, they decide to prepare the corpse for burial. The men go to the nearby villages to see if they're missing a man. The women sew the corpse some clothes to bury him in. While sewing, the oldest woman names him Esteban. After this naming, the women and men then regard the corpse as if he were a saint. They prepare his body as if he were royalty and even select a family from the village to adopt the drowned man. After they bury him at sea, they vow to paint their houses and plant flowers to honor Esteban's memory. Now, the only thing in here that you might complain is a bit subjective is when I say that they treat him like a saint. And that is my opinion, but why is that my opinion? And I tell you right here, this is my evidence. They prepare his body as if it were royalty and select a family from the village to adopt the guy. So even if you put in a little bit of subjectivity, if you can back it up like that, then you still have a really solid summary. Remember, your summary should give somebody who has no idea about the story at all a really good idea about the story. Okay, those are the answers. Leave me comments, leave me feedback if you feel compelled to do so. I will see you in the next video.